Save Our Planet, climate conference held in Oslo, Norway. The fifth annual Zero Emissions Conference brought together concerned dignitaries and experts on November 22nd and 23rd in Oslo, Norway, to discuss climate change issues and specific actions needed in the sectors of power generation, transport, energy production, and agriculture. Supreme Master Television's correspondent reports.
We are here in Oslo at the Clarion Hotel, where the fifth annual Zero Emission Conference is being held. This is the largest meeting of its kind in Scandinavia, and is organized by the Norwegian Environmental Foundation Zero Emission Resource Organization, with the goal of addressing a wide range of topics regarding climate change solutions. Distinguished speakers include Norwegian Prime Minister Jens Stoltenberg, Chairman of the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change and Vegetarian, Dr. Rajendra Pachauri, Deputy Director of UNICEF, Hilde Cranfjord Johnson, Irish singer-songwriter and activist Bob Geldof, President of the World Watch Institute Christopher Flavin, and others. Everyone agreed on the urgency of mitigating climate change.
I wouldn't look for a technological fix, whether we like it or not, and I don't like it, because I've got an enviable lifestyle. We're going to have to temper and ameliorate our life. It doesn't mean going back to the Middle Ages, but we're going to ameliorate our economy, our lifestyle, so that it's more bearable for the planet.
Reforming agriculture and reforming energy are the two most important things we need to do for a stable climate.
If climate change leads to a warmer climate, it is likely to lead to more water scarcity, food insecurity, and worsening health conditions. And in all three areas, we are really worried that children will suffer. So what we have gained in reduction in child mortality the last decades can actually be undermined and maybe be lost if really the worst case scenarios kick in.
We also asked participants to share their thoughts on the important dietary solutions.
A single person can absolutely do a lot in terms of their own consumption. Even the what you eat makes a difference. Less meat, more vegetables will both make you healthier and will also make the climate healthier.
Certainly, lifestyle changes also involve dietary changes, agricultural practices. It will take time, but it will happen, I'm sure. Yeah.
With only days to go before the COP16 meeting in Cancun, attendees are hopeful for constructive global actions. This is Supreme Master Television reporting from Oslo, Norway.
We appreciate the Zero Emission Conference participants for their efforts to find ways to reduce harmful emissions. May everyone realize and share the most viable solution of being meat-free with bountiful organic vegan agriculture for all.